Very good morning, dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are well and healthy. Here, I thought to utilize my time, my students' time, such a pandemic situations where the world is suffering from COVID-19. Today, I am going to discuss here the first chapter of class 10th NCERT Mathematics is real number. And I will explore the different type of numbers such as natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, fraction numbers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. Alright, and in this video I am giving you some questions based on the topic. Please try to solve it and give your answer in my comment boxes. In case if you have any query and any doubt, please drop the message in my comment box. Okay, so let's come on the topic, real numbers. What is real numbers? Real numbers are those numbers which we can express on the number line. Real numbers are those numbers which we can express on the number line. It is denoted by capital R. Let's write the definition of real number. Real numbers are those numbers which we can write on the number line. It is denoted by capital R. Suppose this is a number line and this side is minus infinity and this is plus infinity and zero is somewhere. Those numbers which are lying on the right hand side of zero are positive integers, and which are lying on the left hand side of zero are negative integers. Generally real number is divided into two parts. First one is rational number, second one is irrational number. Real number is divided into two parts. First one is rational number, second one is irrational number. What is rational numbers? In earlier classes we have studied about rational numbers. Rational numbers are those numbers which we can write in the form of P upon Q, where Q does not equal to 0. Rational numbers are those numbers which we can write in the form of P upon Q, where Q does not equal to 0. Okay, then rational number is divided into different numbers. Let's see, first one is natural number. What is natural number? Natural numbers are greater than 0, we can use as a counting numbers. It is denoted by capital N. It begins at 1, 2 till infinity. It begins at 1 till infinity. Then the second one is whole number. Whole number. It is denoted by capital W. What is whole number? Whole number are just a natural number plus zero. Just a natural number plus zero. When we include zero on the natural numbers, then we get whole numbers. When we include zero on the natural number, then we get whole number. Then the third one is integers. What is integers? It is denoted by capital Z. Integers is a whole number that can be positive, negative or zero. What? Integer is a whole number that can be positive, negative or zero. Negative, positive or zero. Then fourth one is fractional numbers. Fractional number. What is fractional number? Fractional numbers are figured out by two whole numbers that can be separated by a horizontal line. Two whole number that can be separated by a horizontal line. Horizontal line 2 by 5, 6 by 4, 2 by 3, and 14 by 11, and so on. Here you can see numerator and denominator is separated by a horizontal line. Then fractional number is divided into two parts. First one is terminating decimals, second one is non-terminating and repeating decimals. What is the meaning of terminating? What is the meaning of terminate? Terminate means when the numerator is completely divisible by its denominator. When the numerator is completely divisible by its denominator. Okay, that's meaning is terminating. That's meaning is terminating. So what is the meaning of terminating decimal? terminating decimal. And the second one is non-terminating and repeating decimal. So here first one is terminating decimal. What is the meaning of terminating decimal? Terminating decimal is the decimal number that contains a finite number of digits after a decimal point. What? That contains a finite number of digits after a decimal point. Okay, we understand this definition with the help of two examples. First one is 2 by 5. You know how to divide these numbers? When we divide 2 by 5, so what we get? We get 0.4. And the second one is 6 by 4. 6 1 just 6. How much carry? 2. This decimal point is here. 20. 4 2 ja 4 2 ja 8. 4 3 ja 12. 4 5 ja 20. I have written two examples here. First one is 2 by 5. When we divide 2 by 5, here we get 0.4. And here we get 1.5. Here you can see clearly after the decimal point. After the decimal point, here is only one digit. Means the number is terminate after the one decimal place. After the one decimal place. Completely divisible after the one decimal place. So that type of numbers are called terminating decimals. Now the second one is non-terminating and repeating decimal. First, see two examples. Then I explained what is the definition of terminating and repeating decimal. I am writing here 2 by 3. When we divide 2 by 3, so we are getting 0.666 and so on. And second one is 14 by 11. When we divide 14 by 11, we are getting 1.272727 and so on. So what is the definition of non-terminating and repeating decimals? Non-terminating and repeating decimal is a decimal number that continues with a group of digits repeating endlessly. Means the digits after the decimal, you can see clearly, after the decimal, the digits are repeating. The digits, देखिए ना आप clearly यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं digit क्या हो रहे हैं आपके decimal के बाद repeat हो रहे हैं. Decimal, this is decimal point, 6666 and so on. Dot dot का meaning क्या होता है? Non terminating. ये terminate नहीं होंगे. ऐसे 66 आते ही रहेगा. And the second one example, you can see 1.272727. यहाँ पे देखो 2727 क्या हो रहा है, बार बार repeat हो रहा है. So that type of numbers are called non-terminating and repeating decimal. ऐसे numbers को कैसे लिखते हैं, in short form में we can write these numbers 0.6 bar and 1.27 bar. That look 0.6 bar, I put the bar on the top of only 6, and here I put the bar on the top of 27. What is the meaning of this? इसका मतलब ये है कि जो भी digit decimal के बाद repeat होगा, केवल हम उसी digit के ऊपर क्या करते हैं, bar को put करते हैं. It means यहाँ पे 6 repeat हो रहा है, तो it means I put the bar on the top of 6 only, and here 27. 27 क्या हो रहा है, बार बार रिपीट हो रहा है, तो इट मीन्स आई पुट द बार ऑन द टॉप ऑफ 27 ओनली. गेटिंग? सो दी टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड रैशनल नंबर्स. रैशनल नंबर, होल नंबर, इंटीजर, फ्रैक्शनल नंबर्स, टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग, टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग, दीज ऑल टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड रैशनल नंबर. देन सेकेंड वन इज इरैशनल नंबर. वॉट इज इरैशनल नंबर? इरैशनल नंबर्स आर दोज नंबर्स विच कैन नॉट राइट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी अपॉन क्यू. You know, we cannot write in the form of P upon Q. Some examples: root 2, root 3, pi, and so on. What is the value of root 2? 1.414213 5, and so on. What is the value of root 3? 1.73 73 28 20 50, and so on. What is the value of pi? 3.14 28 5 7, and so on. Here these type of numbers are called non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. What is the meaning of non-terminating? Non-terminating means continues endlessly with the no group of digits repeating. No group of digits means कोई भी digit जो होगा decimal के बाद आपका repeat नहीं होगा. You can see here 1.414153573205030 3.142857. After the decimal, you can clearly observe that there are different digits. कोई भी डिजिट यहाँ रिपीट नहीं हो रहा है, और एंड सो ऑन डॉट डॉट. तो दैट मीन्स ऐसे नंबर आपके आते ही रहेंगे, तो उन्हें बोलते हैं नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग. एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग मीन्स कोई भी नंबर आपका रिपीट नहीं हो रहा है, कोई भी नंबर आपका सेम नहीं आ रहा है. सो दैट टाइप ऑफ नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग डेसिमल्स. दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इरेशनल नंबर्स. ओके, द फर्स्ट थ्योरम इज यूक्लिड डिविजन लेमा. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लेमा? लेमा इज जस्ट अ स्टेटमेंट, इट डजेंट रिक्वायर एनी प्रूफ. ओके, वॉट लेमा, डिविजन लेमा सेट, फॉर अ गिवन टू पॉजिटिव इंटीजर, फॉर अ गिवन टू पॉजिटिव इंटीजर्स A and B, there exist a unique whole number such that whole numbers Q and R such that A is equal to BQ plus R where R is greater than equal to 0 is less than B where R is greater than equal to 0 less than B. A is equal to BQ plus R. This is the theorem, first theorem of Euclid division lemma. A is equal to BQ plus R. Where A is dividend, B is divisor, Q is quotient, and R is remainder. Where A is dividend, B is divisor, Q is quotient, R is remainder. Okay. Now we will do one question based on the above theorem. What is the first question is, use Euclid's algorithm to find the SCF of 4052 and 12576. Now, how to find the SCF of given two numbers? Let's see the solution. Solution. First condition is, since 12576 is greater than 4052. This is the first step. We will check which one is greater number. Then the greater number will become dividend and the smaller number will become divisor. Greater number will be A, dividend, and the smaller number B will be divisor. Then put A is equal to 12576 is equal to 452 into, compare it, A is 12576, B is this, and we have to find out Q. So how to find out Q? Divide it 12576 by 4052. 4052, 3 2 6, 3 5 15, 1 carry, 3 0 0 1, 3 4 12. Remainder is 0, 0, 0, 6 minus 0. Sorry, 6 minus 6, 0, 7 minus 5, 2, 5 minus 1, 4, 2 minus 2, 0, 1 minus 1. This is quotient, this is remainder. So what is Q? Q is 3, and what is remainder? 4, 20. Now we will apply division lemma for the divisor and remainder. That means, in next line, divisor will become dividend and remainder will become divisor. So 4052 is equal to 420 into Now we have to find out quotient here. Again, divide 4052 by 420. 420, 9 ja. 9 0 ja 0, 9 2 ja 18, 1 carry. 9 4 ja 36 plus 1, 37. Do subtract 2 minus 0, 2. 15 minus 8, 7. 9 minus 7, 2. And 3 minus 3, 0. What is remainder? Quotient is 9 and remainder is 272. Now apply the same process. 420 is equal to remainder is 272 into 272, 1 ja, 272. How much remainder? Do subtract 272 minus this, 10 minus 2, 8. This become 1, carry, so this become 11, 11 minus 7, 4, 3 minus 2, 1. The remainder is 148. Then next line, again, divisor will become dividend and remainder will become divisor. 141 ja, 148 plus how much carry? 272 minus 148. This is coming 12 minus 8, 4, 6 minus 4, 2, 1. Remainder is 124. Then 148 is equal to 124 into 1 plus remainder is 24. Then next line again divisor will become dividend. Remainder will become divisor. 124 is equal to 24 5 ja. 24 5 ja 120. Do subtract 124 minus 120. How much remainder? 24 minus 0 0 4 sorry 2 minus 2 0 1 minus 1 0. This is coming 4. Next line 24 is equal to 4 into 4 kitne ja 6 24 6 ja 4 6 ja 24 plus what is remainder? Remainder is 0. When we get the remainder as 0, in that case the divisor will be the SCF of given two positive integers. Compare it. What is A? A is this now. This is B and this is Q and this is R. Remainder is 0, quotient is 6, divisor B is 4, A is 24. So, what is the SCF? Hence, the SCF of given two integers, hence, 4 is the SCF of, 4 is the SCF of 4052 and 12576. Got it? The next question is, so that every positive even integer is in the form of 2q and that every positive odd integer is in the form of 2q plus 1 where q is some integer. In this question, we have to prove that every positive integer, even integer, is in the form of 2q and every positive odd integer is in the form of 2q plus 1. Let's see the solution. Let A be any positive integer and B is equal to 2. B is equal to 2. I have right here B is equal to 2. How? Because you can compare it. A is equal to BQ plus R. BQ plus R. What is 2Q? 2Q. 2Q. So what is B? B is 2. We don't know what is A, what is Q, what is R. So, B we know here, B is equal to 2. So write A is equal to Euclid division lemma, A is equal to BQ 2Q plus R. A is equal to 2Q plus R. Where? What is R? R is greater than 0. R is greater than equal to 0. Less than equal to B. What is B? 2. That means the possible value of R is, that means R is greater than equal to 0. R is 0, greater than 0, 1, but less than 2. तो less than 2 means 2 से छोटा नंबर कौन सा होता है? 1. तो R, the possible value of R is 0 and 1. Puts the values of R in the given, in the above theorem. A is equal to 2Q plus 0 or this is the first possibility. When we put R equal to 0, you can write R equal to 0, put R equal to 0, so we get A is equal to 2Q plus R, and R equal to 1, so we get A is equal to 2Q plus 1. Okay, you know what odd numbers and even numbers. Odd number 1, 3, 5, 7, odd, even numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. It means those numbers which are divisible by 2 are called even numbers, and which are not divisible by 2 are called odd numbers. So here you can see 0. 0 is even or odd? 0 is even and 1 is odd. Getting? So what is your question? Prove that every positive even integer is in the form of 2q. Every even positive integer is in the form of 2q. 2q and every odd integer and every positive odd integer is in the form of 2q plus 1. This is odd. When we add even number plus odd number, then we will get odd number. Suppose that 2 plus 1, 3, 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 6 plus 1, 7. Because 2q, q is the multiple of 2. So when we do multiply these two numbers, we will get the even number. When we add even number plus odd number, we will get odd number. So this is odd number, the whole will be odd and the whole will be even. Therefore you can write, therefore every positive even integer is in the form of 2q, and every odd integer is in the form of 2q plus 1. Hence proved. Yes, got it? So dear students, please try these questions. I have given three questions here. First one is, which of the following is terminating, non-terminating and repeating, and non-terminating and non-repeating. You have to check out all four parts, okay, which one is terminating, which one is non-terminating, repeating, and which one non-terminating and non-repeating. You can divide it, then write the answer: terminating, non-terminating, terminating, repeating, and non terminating, non repeating. Now the second one question is, use Euclid's division lemma, find the SF of falling. You have to use the Euclid division lemma and find out the SF of 42 and 183 and 38 and 228. Now the third one is, identify rational and irrational numbers. See the numbers, this one, which one, if this is rational to write R, if this is irrational to write IR and R, whatever the answer is. So please try these questions and give your answers in my comment box so that I can solve your problems as soon as possible. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.